Good day.
Good day.
Kidlets.
Kidlets, that's a new one.
I just went for it.
I like it.
Okay, so today is the final week of Blueprints.
That's crazy. This month just kind of flew by, but here we are.
It flew by.
Yeah. Okay, so we have a game, of course. And this game we're gonna play, and you guys get to play, which is kind of fun. So this game is called Emoji Bible Stories.
Ooh.
And what's gonna happen is we're gonna flash like 5 or 6 emojis up on the screen. And based off of those emojis, we have to figure out what Bible story they're based off of. Makes sense?
You gotta connect the dots, boop, 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 between the emojis to form your story and use your brain juices to figure out where it goes in the Bible.
Right. Yep, that's it. Okay, let's start with an easier one. So this is the first one. If you can figure out the answer, just go ahead and shout it out and we'll work on it too. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, we got it.
Girl.
Lady and a guy.
Boy, son, apple snake.
Apple snake.
Adam and Eve. Yeah. Great.
Well, the finger though, is that like, hey, you guys get out of the garden?
You're wrong, get out. Probably.
You go, get out of here.
That's what it is,
okay,
yep.
Cool.
Okay, next one, here we go.
Next one.
Crown, prayer, lion, and praise.
There's only a few, I feel like, that have lion as the main part.
That's very true.
And some, they're clapping, so something great happened at the end.
Yep.
I want to say lion, something great, king, prayer,
Daniel and the lion's den.
Seems like it's right.
Okay, here we go. We got 2 elephants.
Uh-huh.
Rain. Rainbow boat.
A big fat boat.
Okay.
Only half of one. Is that important?
I'm gonna say no.
Okay.
Because I think I know what this is.
What do you think it is?
Noah's Ark.
That makes sense. Yep.
Cool.
Okay.
Now we've got a runner. Another boat.
Okay.
A whale. This is a full boat this time, if that says anything. A whale and prayer hands.
A whale.
Okay, so somebody's running.
Yep.
They get on a boat. Okay, I think the whale really gives this one away.
The whale kind of does.
What do you think?
Jonah and the whale.
Jonah
probably.
And
although
the whale.
It's big fish. It may not have been a whale. Who knows?
That's true. Could have just been a big fish.
It's been a big fish.
All right, next one. Okay, we've got the number 7. A little circle thing. Trumpet.
Yep.
Picture of a city.
Okay.
And a big X. This one's a little harder.
Maybe. I don't know, the earth was created in 7 days, buildings, God's building things, the earth.
But what about the trumpet?
What's the X? The trumpet?
Okay, I'm feeling Old Testament. And, okay, but remember the story? I think I know what this is. Remember the story, they blow all the trumpets, the walls fall down, what's that?
Oh, yeah. Jericho.
Jericho.
Jericho, that's what it is.
Yep, we got it. The fall of Jericho.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, I know what this one is, right off the bat.
Yeah, this one's a little bit easier. We've got fish, we've got loaves, and we've got a lot of people.
Mm-hmm. We got the story of the 5,000 fed with 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread.
That's true. Did you guys get that one? Okay, now we have a man, a tree, a fire, and a word blurb.
Is that
what they're called?
Tree?
Word blurbs?
Word blurbs? Word bubbles.
Word bubbles.
Word bubbles.
Kind of like blurb better, but.
I think it's not a tree. I think it's a bush.
Oh, does that give you guys any other clues?
Bush.
A burning bush.
Burning flame. Burning bush.
Moses in the burning bush.
Yes.
That's what it is. Okay, we've got a sheep. We've got a man. We've got this.
Rock on.
Rock on. Okay, I'm kind of leaning towards it's a shepherd because of the sheep.
Oh, good call.
And a shepherd that maybe killed somebody.
Oh.
And I think a story like that is in the Old Testament.
Rock on. There's a
what
rock.
What is that? A rock.
Uh-huh.
Maybe right to the forehead, like the target.
Right in the bullseye.
We've got David and Goliath. That was a good one.
Where he slings a rock and kicks him in the bullseye right there.
Which apparently your forehead is the bullseye.
Yeah.
So.
But
it worked.
Everybody
it killed
knows
him,
that.
So. Yeah. All right, next one. Okay. Pregnant lady, donkey,
star.
Or a horse.
This could also be rock star.
That's true. We've got a star and a baby.
Okay.
This one's a little bit easier.
Yeah.
I'm thinking.
A famous pregnant lady and a donkey.
I wonder
and a baby.
Who it could be.
I think it's probably...
the birth of Jesus.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay.
Oh. A man, a word bubble.
Three X's. A rooster.
A rooster.
Chicken, hen. And
it's got the face. It's got the little gobbler. I think it's probably a rooster.
Okay, I think I know what this one is.
Me too. Peter denies Jesus
three times. And then what happens after he denies Jesus three times?
The rooster crows.
He's sad, which makes sense. That was a good one. Okay, a baby, a basket. Got a little like.
Is that
girl with a crown?
Is that El what? Capitan?
What flag is that? Okay, so this kind of maybe reminds me of Moses
and the river?
Yeah, getting sent down. Yep, okay, we got it. The birth of Moses.
That one had me sweating.
Okay, so now we have plate, bread, wine, sponge, and feet. I was thinking maybe Jesus turns water into wine, but I don't think that would make sense with the rest of it. Mm-hmm. Okay, it looks like
maybe
washing
it's
feet.
Talking about making your feet so clean that you could eat and drink off of your feet.
I don't know that that's in the Bible, but I do recall a story where Jesus just washes people's feet.
Yeah.
And that happens at
and
the
he talks supper. About the bread and the wine and how it's his body and blood. So
yep.
I think it's the Last Supper.
Nailed it. That was a blast.
Okay.
I liked that game. How'd you guys do? Did you guys get some?
What was your score? What was your tally? Did you beat the people you're playing with?
I beat him, just so everybody knows. Okay, well, I think we should go worship.
Okay.
Feel the wonder, say his name. Watch the darkness slip away. Put your power on display. Say goodbye to fear and shame.
We won't stop coming after you. We won't move until you move. Come and do what only you can do. Come and do what only you can do. We won't stop coming after you. We won't move until you move. Come and do what only you can do. Come and do what only you can do.
We've been working on these awesome Lego sets. I had the lion, Jared had the
ice cream truck, Mr. Chill ice cream with a handy dandy window to deliver the ice cream through.
Nice. Now, Lego sets are fun to make, but we actually did have a reason for building them. This whole month, we've been talking about God's plans for our lives. Mm-hmm. And plans are often called blueprints. Sometimes it takes God's plans a while to unfold, though. Kind of like how it's taken us some time to complete these Lego sets.
Yeah.
Just like these Legos, we may not be able to see what God's plans are or what He might be doing, but little by little, God shows us the amazing things that are in store for us. We'll see more of that in our Bible story.
Yeah. Okay, so everybody, we want you to go grab your Bibles, and
we want you to open up
to where I have it open to, which is Mark 11, verse 1. And we'll be going through verse 11, okay? Are we ready to read? Do you have your Bibles? Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Okay. As they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethpage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and just as you enter it, you will find a colt, or a horse, tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you doing this?' say, 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here shortly.'" They went and found a colt outside in the street, tied at a doorway. As they untied it, some people standing there asked, "What are you doing, untying that colt?" And they answered, as Jesus had told them to, and the people let them go. When they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks over it, he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, while others spread branches they had cut in the fields. Those who went ahead and those who followed shouted, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Jesus entered Jerusalem and went into the temple courts. He looked around at everything, but since it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12.
If you were there that day, what do you think you would have been doing? Fetching the donkey? Laying down your coat on the donkey? Waving palm branches? Maybe putting palm branches on the ground? Mm-hmm. What I love about this story is that everybody played a part. Jesus asked the disciples to get the donkey to ride, and some other people put their coats on the donkey, while others put branches on the road. And then some people were there just to celebrate.
So everyone shouted and praised as they welcomed Jesus into the city of Jerusalem. The people called out to Jesus saying, "Hosanna." So Hosanna means to save. When the people were shouting it, they were asking Jesus to save them. Everybody thought that Jesus would be the kind of king that would help them build their own nation and rule. But God's master plan was about more than that. It's true that God sent Jesus to save everybody, but it was to save them from their sin.
We are all loved the same by God because Jesus came to save all of us. When God made the plan of sending Jesus, God did it with you in mind. Even though we weren't a part of that day, how amazing is it that we're included in God's eternal plan? Let's learn more about this in Grow TV.
Okay.
No, oh no, where is he? He should have been here by now. Oh, hey there, kids. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Come on, this is crazy. Why isn't he here yet? Hey, kids. Sorry if it looks like I'm panicking. Because I am panicking! You see, we had a light plan for Grow TV today, but can you guess where my co-host Andy is? If you guess anywhere right beside me, then you're right. He's not here. Now everything I had planned is ruined. Wait a minute. What if I did everything I was planning on doing with Andy, but just did it by myself? That's it. I can do that. Let's get started. First, we usually start off the day with a high five. Or a handshake. Or a hug. All right. Next, joke time. Knock, knock. Next on the list, it's playing catch. Hey. Well, all that was useless.
Carl.
Andy.
I'm so sorry I'm late.
Where have you been?
I'm so sorry, man. I completely forgot we had Grow TV today. I was just at home feeding my pet tiger, and then I just realized what time it was, and I came home.
What? You have a pet tiger?
You don't?
No. I do not have a pet tiger.
Huh, interesting. Anyway, I'm here to do all the things that we had planned today, all right? But first, high five. High five, Carl. Up top. I said high five. Carl, did you hear me?
I don't wanna.
Why didn't you give me a high five, man?
I guess I'm just not in the mood.
Well, that stinks. Is everything okay?
Well, I guess I'm just a little disappointed.
What? Why?
I don't know. I guess I was expecting a really fun day, and then when I realized you weren't coming in, I tried to do the plan all by myself.
And?
And it didn't work!
Well, yeah.
What?
High fives, jokes, games, those things aren't supposed to be done by themselves. I mean, that doesn't even sound fun.
Yeah, it definitely wasn't.
You know, even Jesus didn't do everything by himself.
Really? Seems like he wouldn't need the help of the others.
Well, let's look at Mark 11. Grab the Bible.
You grab it.
You're closer.
Fine. Alrighty. Yeah. Oh, this is where Jesus rides into Jerusalem.
It sure is. Jesus was heading there to finish out God's plan by saving everyone. But this was a very special time that a lot of people were looking forward to for a very long time.
Really? Why?
You see, what Jesus was about to do was predicted long before Jesus was even born.
Well, that seems to happen a lot with Jesus.
It's true, because Jesus was the savior and the king that all the prophets from the Old Testament had talked about. So what does it say happened before Jesus showed up in Jerusalem?
Well, several things. It mentions that some people went to go get some sort of key.
A key?
Yeah, a key to use when they were done. Maybe to open a door?
Let me see. Carl, it says they went to go get a donkey. Donkey.
Oh, a donkey. I was gonna say, a donkey definitely is not a thing. But why not ride something more exciting, like a camel or an elephant?
The donkey was actually a symbol of peace at that time, and a horse would have been a good idea, but it represented a lot of kingdoms back then that weren't about peace at all. They were about war and stuff. Jesus wanted to show that God's plan would be about peace.
Then it says that once the donkey was with Jesus, someone put a cloak on the donkey so Jesus could sit on it. Well, then there are some people that took off their cloaks and laid them on the ground for Jesus. And others grabbed branches to put down on the ground.
You know why they did that?
Was it because it was laundry day and their clothes were too clean, so they had to dirty them up before they had to wash them?
Not quite. It was actually a way to show respect for people who were really important, like kings.
Like Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
That is so cool. Oh, and look here. It even says people were singing to and about Jesus. They were worshiping God through all of it.
Yep, I'd say Jesus had a pretty good entrance into Jerusalem.
I'd say so too.
You know what I like most about this whole story?
Please don't say it was the key.
No, it was the fact that none of that would have ever happened if it wasn't for everyone pitching in and doing their part.
I mean, I guess you're right. I mean, you had people fetching donkeys, laying down their clothes and branches, singing. No way someone could do that all by themselves.
Not a chance. But God's plan for people wasn't just for them to participate in Jesus entering Jerusalem. It was much bigger than that. This king that they were welcoming into the city was going to save them and bring them closer to God.
So God's plan involved people, but it was also about people.
That's right. So even though I messed up today's plans and didn't make you feel included, just know you are always included in God's plans.
I guess you're right. I am included in God's plans.
Wait, that's our big idea.
No, it's not.
It is.
Are you sure?
Yeah, look at the script.
That's our big idea!
Today's big idea is I'm included in God's plan.
So let's say it out loud on the count of three. Ready?
Ready.
One,
two,
three.
I'm included in God's plan.
Yes, I am. And so are you. And so is Andy. So the plan shall be moved forward. Hence now with God's plan.
Forevereth.
Forevereth.
And evereth.
Cooleth.
Well, Carl, we learned a lot today. But I hope you know I'm really sorry for being late.
No worries. I forgive you. But don't let it happen again. Or else.
Or else? Or else what?
I'm just kidding.
Okay. See you next week.
Watch your bag, Andy.
Who said that?
Oh, I don't know.
Did you hear that?
No, I didn't hear anything. Watch your bag.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of Grow TV.
While Jesus was riding through Jerusalem on the donkey, God's whole plan had not yet unfolded. But we know that not long after that day, God's plan for Jesus to die for my sins and for your sins mm-hmm. happened. And not long after that, his plan for Jesus to rise from the dead also happened. Everything that God had planned happened, and that continues to happen today.
Sometimes we can forget that God is still working. Sometimes it can feel like there's no plan for our lives or for the world, but God is still working each and every day. And his ultimate plan is to save us and bring us into heaven with him. And that plan, it won't fail. That day really will come. I'm so glad that I am included in God's plan.
So before we worship, let's read our memory verse one more time. Sometimes on Kidzone Online, we joke about forgetting the memory verse, but truthfully, memory verses are an awesome tool that we need to be reminded that God loves us and has a plan for us. So let's read our memory verse, which is Jeremiah 29:11. All right, so here it is. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future.
This is definitely a verse that I hope to remember for a long time. It reminds me that God is still working and is still in control and is working for my good. Mm-hmm. Let's go and worship and thank him that he included us in his plans. that's it for our Blueprint series.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Next week, we're gonna start another series called Whoop, Rise Up, because we're gonna be packing our bags and rising up and hiking into the mountains.
Hitting the road to hike a mountain.
Figuratively. But next week's Easter.
Yeah.
So we're gonna talk about how Jesus rose from the dead and how we can rise up to face the challenges in our life.
Yeah.
But speaking of rising up though, I'm curious. What is the highest thing you have ever climbed or gone on?
Well, I don't really know, but one time at summer camp, I climbed like a telephone pole, and then you have to stand on the top, and then you're all strapped in, and then you jump off, and then you have to try to like grab this bar, but it was pretty high, pretty terrifying. It's like one of those ones where you get to the top and your legs are shaking because it's so high, but I'm not really scared of heights, so it was fine. Yeah. What about you?
It wasn't something I climbed. It was a little ride I went on. It was like 350 feet tall. It was like this big, tall pole, and then you're strapped into these seats, and it brings you up, and then it like shoots you down and pushes you down,
that's
and you're just
terrible.
Like,
is it one that you wait at the top?
Yeah.
That's the worst.
You wait up there, you're like looking down and around for like 5 seconds before, you know.
You fall.
Crazy. You fall. They push you down.
Crazy.
Anyway.
Well, thanks for joining us, guys. We're excited to see you next week for our series called Rising Up. See ya.
Bye.